Welcome to Protein & Co. Here we are the lead producer of quality proteins of the finest grade. We can guarantee no matter how big or small, 99.89% accuracy of every protein's amino acid sequence, or your money back. Our efficient assemblage, broad protein selection, and outstanding customer service allows us to be ranked number one in protein production. Out of breath lately? Feeling sick? Something not right? No need to fret, all you need is a protein. We'll match you up with the perfect protein, allowing you to live a full and vigorous life. Most importantly, we want to see you cherish what matters most. That's right, we here at Protein & Co. are dedicated to satisfying our customers. This short presentation will allow you a brief glimpse into our production and assembly line. We start with a basic strand of DNA, officially known as deoxyribonucleic acid, which is housed in the nucleus. We simply build upon what is already written. That's right. DNA carries all the genetic information, making it an instruction book for building proteins. We simply follow the instructions, add the ingredients, process, and presto, a protein. The twisted ladder shape of DNA is called a double helix. The outside is a sugar phosphate backbone. Inside are the rungs of the ladder, nucleotides. These nucleotides are adenine, cytosine, guanine, and thymine. These can be represented by A, C, G, and T. Like magnets, only certain parts can pair. Adenine always pairs with thymine, and guanine always pairs with cytosine. First, we'll show you how we produce DNA. To provide for our growing worldwide customers, we need thousands of strands of DNA. The demand is ever increasing, so how do we get more of this macromolecule? Through a process called replication. When we replicate a strand of DNA, we require an existing strand. Copying DNA requires DNA and a mixture of enzymes. Unfortunately, DNA cannot be replicated by scratch. To start the process, we release a special enzyme called helicase. This enzyme unwinds the DNA into two separate strands. Time to get to work. The first strand of the DNA is called the leading strand. We introduce another enzyme called DNA polymerase, which adds matching nucleotides to this leading strand. The other strand is called the lagging strand. This strand requires more help. RNA primase comes in and adds short segments of RNA primer. These segments are called Okazaki fragments. DNA polymerase 3 lays nucleotides in between the pieces of RNA primer. DNA polymerase 1 then replaces the RNA primers with nucleotides. DNA ligase finishes the process up by fusing the broken segments, forming a phosphodiester bond. Thus, this whole process creates two new strands of DNA from only one. With our new DNA strand, it is our job to produce your protein. To that, we need some more help from enzymes. DNA is, as you know, made of letters. Every three letters is called a codon. One codon codes for one amino acid. A chain of amino acids makes one protein. One whole section of DNA capable of coding for one protein is what we call a gene. You see how important DNA is to us? Without it, we can't produce proteins. Without proteins, there is no you, or life for that matter. It all begins with transcription. To kickstart our protein production, we need RNA. Think of RNA as a copycat DNA, a prototype, so to speak, a mold. Into this mold, we pour amino acids, which form a protein. Let's introduce RNA polymerase. This helpful enzyme finds a specific sequence in DNA called a promoter. It then binds to it. The promoter identifies the start of a gene, which strand is to be copied, and the direction that it is to be copied. The RNA polymerase unwinds and rewinds the DNA and produces bases that are matching to one of the strands. In place of thymine is uracil. A special termination code in the DNA indicates where transcription will stop. The mRNA produced is called an mRNA transcript. M stands for messenger. This mRNA will need to be processed. Introns are regions of the genes that are not translated into proteins. Therefore, they are removed, leaving only exons, which are the protein instructions. The exons are spliced together to form a mature mRNA transcript. This mRNA travels outside the nucleus into the cytoplasm. Now starts translation. The finished product is now to be made. A special cellular organelle called a ribosome attaches to the mRNA and then moves along it, adding amino acids to a chain called a polypeptide chain. As the ribosome moves along the mRNA, it requires specific amino acids. tRNA, or transfer RNA, deliver the required amino acid as it is attached to them. There is a specific tRNA for each of the 20 different amino acids. The three-letter bases attached to the tRNA are called anticodon. The tRNA line up with the mRNA in the ribosome due to matching bases. The amino acids then bind. The tRNA then drops off to be reused later. The ribosome continuously processes the mRNA, the tRNA continuously binding and delivering their amino acids. As production continues, the amino acids assemble outside the ribosome, twisting into conformation. When finished, the amino acids, due to bonds between each other, have the shape and function of a new protein.
Congratulations on the creation of a new masterpiece. Every protein produced here is created with only the highest of standards, guaranteed by our monthly USDS inspections and daily facility maintenance. From here, your protein will be inspected, packaged, and shipped worldwide right to your front door, hassle-free. If you're considering the purchase of a protein, you can be assured of total functionality and conformation with the purchase of a protein from Protein & Co. With a 30-day warranty and many positive reviews, we urge you to call now for a free interview with one of our quality health officials. But wait, there's more! Call now in the next hour and you'll receive a $250 reduction on all globular proteins. What are you waiting for?